And President Trump and former Vice President Biden are back on the campaign trail after their debate on Tuesday. Natalie Brand has the latest from the White House.
At a rally in Minnesota last night, President Trump touted his debate performance against Democratic rival Joe Biden.
You know, Biden lost badly when his supporters are saying he should cancel the rest of the debates.
But the president is dealing with the fallout after controversial comments he made when asked to denounce white supremacy Tuesday night.
Would you like me to condemn
white supremacists and right
Proud Boys? Stand back and stand by.
Wednesday, President Trump tried to walk back those comments.
They have to stand down, let law enforcement do their work.
On Capitol Hill, Senate Republicans pressed the president to clarify.
He should have made it very clear that there is no room for people on the far left or the far right when it comes to either Antifa or these white supremacist groups.
Campaigning across Ohio and Pennsylvania, former Vice President Joe Biden said his message to the Proud Boys is cease and desist.
The Proud Boys now have a logo saying, stand down, but stand by. We need to remember who in God's name we are. This is the United States of America.
After Tuesday's chaos, the commission that oversees presidential debates is now considering changes to the rules to try and keep order. CBS News has learned that could include cutting off candidates' microphones.
Even members of the president's own party criticized the tone of debate night.
I did not think it was helpful in educating the American people.
I thought it was an embarrassment.
With 33 days until the election, both the president and Biden are focusing on raising money. The president holds a private fundraiser in Bedminster, New Jersey today, while Democratic nominee Joe Biden will fundraise virtually. On Friday, Biden heads to the key battleground state of Michigan, while the president has a trip planned to the swing state of Florida. Natalie Brand, CBS News, The White House.
CBS News has confirmed President Trump's former campaign manager has resigned from the campaign. And a British judge says a decision will be made in January on whether WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange will be extradited to the U.S. U.S. attorneys accuse Assange of plotting to hack government computers and violating an espionage law. His lawyers argue that conditions in U.S. prisons breach Britain's human rights laws and that he and his lawyers have been spied on. Assange made international headlines in 2010 when WikiLeaks published a U.S. military video showing a helicopter attack in Baghdad that killed a dozen people. And a sunrise ceremony this morning marks 3 years since the deadly mass shooting in Las Vegas. Clark County Sheriff Joe Lombardo told a small crowd that the death toll from the shooting has went up to 60. Two more people have died after a gunman opened fire on a music festival crowd on October 1st, 2017. Governor Steve Sisolak says memories from that horrible day remain fresh. And the biggest shopping center in the country is helping out some of Minnesota's struggling small businesses. That's next on Valley News Live at 4.